Chairs is the organization that runs Creation Sessions. We've been doing this session every week on Sundays for just over 10 years. The premise of the evening is that we all gather and support an artist for an opening set, and then after that opening set, we open things up into a jam session, and it's all fully improvised. So we'll do that until about 10 o'clock after the first set starts. Usually things are within the realm of free improvisation, avant-garde, creative music, and tonight that is still true. We're very excited to be hosting trumpeter Gregg Kelley, and Gregg is taking a slight aside tonight and presenting a bugle set. I get the feeling that most of the people in the room are familiar with Gregg's playing and music. I know I am a big fan and happy to call him a friend too. And I thought it was really weird that Gregg's never done a research session. And so we're correcting that tonight. So if you'll all help me give him a warm welcome.
Thank you. Yeah, my idea today was I have this thing. It was hanging on the wall in the basement near the laundry when I was growing up. And I took it off years ago and played it, and it's got kind of a nice tone. And I used it a couple of times, but for some reason, I don't know why, but Haley asked me to do this, and I said, I can't just go out and just do my usual thing, so I have to do something different. I have to challenge myself in some way. So a lot of what I do anyways is about constraints or limitations. So this seemed like a pretty severe limitation to what I usually do, and I'm not using any mutes. I use some metal plates sometimes, but I'm not using any of that. So, and then after for the open session, a suggestion is to impose some kind of limitation on yourself. It doesn't have to be very strict, so you don't have to play an instrument that cuts your vocabulary into a quarter, but whatever that means to you, just something to consider. And then we had a loss this week in the experimental underground community of the United States, Davey Williams, who's an amazing guitar player from Alabama, who was an early musician in the States doing abstract, a little bit Dadaist improvisation, passed away this weekend. And I think I met him once through Wally Shoup, who has played a lot with him. And I think that he would appreciate the absurdity of what I'm about to do. So I'm going to dedicate this set to him, and his spirit will be running through the night.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I don't even know if the horse is off.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. you guys setting up, I'm going to indulge myself, if you don't mind. Just as one thing, I can tell stories about Davey Williams all night long. And you just got to go check Davey out. He's dead now. More people will find out about him. He was a blues musician, white blues musician from Alabama who played with Johnny Shines, if you know who he was. He was a contemporary of Robert Johnson. Then he morphed into a surrealist free improviser. Derek Bailey actually sent him early, little Derek Bailey, real to real. Anyway, Davey was funny. He was a little guy, so he was funny and cheeky, but he was never intimidating. So he came out. The Earshot Jazz people brought him out here at Ira Hess to play at the back room, the speakeasy, where he proceeded to play blues and loops and all this. But every now and then, he had this little rubber duck. He'd step on it. No rhyme or reason, ever in time, while he was playing, when he wasn't playing. And he was masterful, and people dug him. And at the very end, he says, oh, by the way, that's for the jazz people. And that was kind of a parting comment. So he's like, oh, okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay.
And then you were one of them.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's awesome.
That was fun.
case
Thank you. Thank you.
Davey had without really trying too hard. And we'll see you next week.